Om Sai Ram. So we are going to discuss today part 4 and part 5. So first we will take part 4 of Indian culture and heritage. So what is the objective of present part? We are going to discuss general characteristics of culture. By now you must have understood some characteristics of culture with the example that we gave you. So the first is, culture is learned and acquired. As we told you that these traits of culture we learn from our family members, and these family members learn from their family members, from the group and society in which we live. So culture is learned and acquired. Acquired meaning you have got it from your family. And you have learnt it from your family and your society. So culture is thus being influenced by the physical and social environment through which they operate. So physical environment is where you live, your house, your neighborhood, and the social environment is the society, which is carrying the values, the cultural values, and that society, those cultural values are given to you. You learn it through them. Culture is shared by a group of people. What does this mean? That it is shared and it is practiced by a group of people. So your family will be practicing the same kind of culture, food, dress, similar culture, language. Your neighborhood will be following the similar kind of culture. Your entire extended family will also be following the similar kind of culture, which comes from your own cultural background. So this is how we can say culture is shared. Then culture is cumulative. What is the meaning of cumulative? That different traits of culture, new aspects of culture, also keep coming and being added to culture. Time to time, from one generation to another generation. So this cycle remains as the particular culture goes with time. So it acquires. If you see your own culture, then you will see that something you have taken from your family, from the traditional part of your family, and something you have added to it. Look at the language. Language is a part of culture. So you earlier in Karnataka, which language? Only Kannada was spoken. Now, Kannada with some part of, you know, you can add some Telugu words into that. You can add some Hindi word into that. And you can add some English words also. That is your language. So all those new things you have acquired and you have added into your culture. So I have given you an example of language. You can take an example of your dress also. How you wear and how your forefathers used to wear the dresses. So today's what kind of dresses you are wearing is a part of your Kannada culture, Karnataka culture, and part of all over Indian culture, sometimes English Western culture also. So this is how culture keeps accumulating things in itself. This is how we can say culture is cumulative. Then culture changes. That means culture is dynamic. So, culture is never static. It changes as the time passes. It never remains in the permanent state. It is always changing constantly. How? New ideas, new techniques are added. And as the time passes, some old things are modified, changing the old ways. So, this is also cumulative in quality. So this is how we can say culture is dynamic. Dynamic means something which can change, which is not opposite to static. Then culture gives us a range of permissible behavior patterns. It involves how an activity should be conducted, how an individual should act appropriately. So very relevant example, if you come to this, your educational institutes here in the ashram, certain kind of behavior is expected out of you. That you will be not speaking much, you will be mostly silent, you will be speaking quietly, not shouting. You will be speaking with a lot of respect to your peers as well as your teachers. So this is about how you will speak, how you will walk. You will not be running helter-skelter. You will be taking care of who all are walking with you. All those things, how you will sit. You will sit in a very alert manner. All these are part of your culture. This is the culture which is permitted here in this campus. Similarly, when you go back to your home, it may be similar to this culture or maybe a bit different from that culture. In your home, you may be allowed certain things which you are not allowed here. So this is how the culture will tell you what things are permitted and what things are not permitted. Culture is diverse. So it is a system that has several mutually interdependent parts. Although these parts are separate, they are interdependent with one another, forming culture as a whole. So what do we mean that culture is diverse? First, if we take only one quality of culture, maybe language. Language is very diverse. As I had given you the example, your Kannada language may be having some inputs of English, something from Hindi, something from Telugu, something from Marathi also, like that. So one part of culture, I have given you the example of a language. And the entire culture system can also be diverse. You may be speaking Kannada language, but you may be eating North Indian food because you like it and it is available. That is also a traditional part. So you can imbibe various things. You can put various things into your own culture and your culture will change. In the sense, it will not change but modify. It will add many things onto it. I hope you have understood. And these are all interdependent on one another. So then they form the culture as a whole. So the whole culture, all parts of culture are interdependent. So when you say Karnataka culture, Kannada language, dance and drama, Yakshagan, all those things are when combined, they give culture of Karnataka. So all these are interdependent and they make one whole culture. Next point, culture is ideational. Ideational meaning? Often it lays down an ideal pattern of behavior that are expected to be followed by individuals so as to gain social acceptance from the people with the same culture. So it is a similar point as the sixth point where it said that the range of permissible behavior patterns. So here also your behavior pattern should be permissible and accepted by the people. If you start shouting and jumping around in the campus, will it be permitted? It won't be permitted. The culture of the campus is that you first care for others. So if we try to become selfish, will it be in line with the culture that is being propagated? No. So then we have to imbibe the culture which is prevalent at that particular place. So I hope you have understood. These were the general characteristics of culture. Now, let's take the importance of culture in human life. So, what is the importance of culture in human life? Without culture, we cannot be called humans only. So, culture is made up of traditions, beliefs, way of life. Why? Because we live together. So many people live together. So, culture is a way of life. How we live together with each other, giving respect and place to each other. Respecting each other's way of living also and learning from each other. We learn so many cuisine, that is food, how to cook food from each other, how to wear from each other, how to speak nicely from each other. Each other's traditional stories, all these things we learn from each other and we behave more like humans. Without culture, our lives will be more like animals. Animals too follow some kind of culture, but it is not civic culture. Our culture is civic culture. When we take care of others, then it is called a civic culture. We know that if we shout, we are going to disturb others. If we are talking incessantly, we are going to disturb the people who want to stay silent. So these kind of things make us human, that we take care of other people also. And we know that culture is made up of traditions, beliefs, way of life, and from the most spiritual to the most material. So culture can give you most spiritual part also. For example, we learned our Vedas, scriptures, our all those things which tell you that you are a spirit, you are not the body only. Body is just an instrument. So all that is taught by what? By the Indian culture, which is based so much on the Vedas. So that is the highest form of culture. Plus, it can give you most material part of culture. That also we learnt in the first chapter. That material aspect of culture is how we look, how things are shown. Your buildings, your architecture, your dressing style, your furniture. These things are the material part of culture. So this is very closely linked with the life. It is what it is said, it is an ornament that we as human beings can use. Rather, we have to use them to be called human beings. Otherwise, we will not be any different from the monkeys that are jumping around in our campus. So culture is what makes us different from the animals. A fundamental element of culture is the issue of religious belief and its symbolic expressions. So you know that if we can take an example, you can take, Muslim religion. So there are some symbolic expressions of that religion. That is also a part of culture. That also we studied in the first chapter. Symbols are a part of culture, any religion. So it will have some, for example, crescent and a star. That is a part of Muslim culture. Quran, their holy book, that is also a part of their culture. So this is their culture is represented by some symbols. So we must value religion's identity and be aware of current efforts to make progress in terms of interfaith dialogue, which is actually an intercultural dialogue. So we should not be only bound with our own culture. We should be open to learn from others' cultures also, and we should respect them. That is what is meant by intercultural dialogue. And as the world becomes more and more global, we have to coexist. So we cannot say that only my culture is great and your culture is not good. If we say like that, can we go to any other country and can we respect them? If we can't respect them, they will also not respect us. So in the today's time, when it is a global culture, then we have to give and take from each other. And you know what's in our campus, what Swami is doing? All our Vedas and our Upanishads are being translated into so many other languages. Why? So that they also learn the good things from our culture. So the culture is all expansive. It is not restricted to one place. Good things should always be learnt. So the three eternal and universal values of truth, beauty and goodness are closely linked with culture. Satyam, Shivam and Sundaram. It is a culture that brings us closer to truth through philosophy and religion. It brings beauty in our lives through the arts and makes us aesthetic beings. And it is culture that makes us ethical beings by bringing us closer to other human beings and teaching us the values of love, tolerance and peace. So what happens when we come together? We learn arts, we learn other things, good things from other people. That is called aesthetics. That is, we develop an artistic streak in us. We try to appreciate art and culture when we come together with other cultures. Also, we learn and we teach the values of love, tolerance and peace. Tolerance you will love when you are with other culture people also. Okay, so that was the end of it. Now, you give the answer to these questions. What is meant by permissible behavior patterns? You will find the answer from, if I can give you a hint, from the sixth point of general characteristics of culture. How can you say that culture is dynamic? You can say that culture is dynamic as no culture remains on the permanent state. It is cumulative. It keeps adding onto itself new aspects of culture from other cultures also. What does culture provide for a decent life? You already know that culture provides us values. It provides us with tolerance, peace, so that we can live in harmony with each other. We learn good things from each other and we live a good and decent life. Which individual would be called uncultured in society? You think about it and you can answer this question. Look at this picture, how diversity is also there, but people are still combined by each other, with each other, through a global culture, that they all respect each other's culture. Okay, and the new values of culture are equality, even in diversity. And it's a global culture, that we should not restrict our culture only to ourselves. And you have already seen such a varied and colorful culture is there in our country. We should be so proud of our country. See how beautiful, colorful is our country with the help of all these cultures being together. India is a very tolerant and a very welcoming country for all kinds of culture. So you can look at these pictures and you can see what are the various aspects of culture. Language, working schedule, medical cure, religion, child rearing methods, food, folk arts, celebrations, jokes, manners, clothes and dressings, all these are a part of a culture. It is just a fun slide. It is just to make the things easier for you. Thank you. Om Sai Ram.